Tonight on a child abuse investigation in Monroe County, this is a picture of the 12-year-old boy from this past year. Florida investigators say that photo from last December shows no sign of abuse.
But now there are more and more questions being raised tonight because that little boy, Eduardo Posso, died in central Indiana just last week. And investigators say there were signs of extreme abuse.
It is a very troubling case. Our Haley Bull has been on this story from the beginning, and she's finding out more tonight about the allegations. Haley, what do we know?
Dan Fanchon, Eduardo's mom says she tried to alert authorities. In fact, investigators in Florida say they looked into multiple allegations reported to them from different sources, but say they never saw any signs of abuse or neglect.
Every time I tried, nobody would want to listen.
Eduardo Posso's mom says she tried to speak up when she thought something wasn't right.
I went crazy. I didn't show him anything, but I was in my mind thinking of, what can I do? Oh my God, I have to do something because this is not right.
But now her 12-year-old son is dead and his father and stepmother are behind bars. Monroe County investigators say they found signs of abuse. But in Florida, the sheriff's office says,
you know, looking back at it, it's just, we feel very confident that we did everything that we could to find signs of abuse and neglect, and they did not exist at that time.
Investigators believe the family traveled promoting circuses, arriving to Bloomington only recently, but previously lived in Manatee County, Florida. The sheriff's office there says they investigated 5 allegations starting in March 2017, including from Eduardo's biological mother. Some incident reports show concerns about bruising and explanations that they came from jumping on the trampoline or missing clubs while practicing juggling.
Time we had the same result. There were no signs of neglect, no signs of abuse.
The last investigation at the end of 2018, when the sheriff's office says this photo was taken.
The child, Eduardo, was able to talk to us and denied that there had been any abuse. He was seemingly healthy, seemingly happy.
Same month as this photo, the school district of Manatee County says Eduardo was withdrawn to be homeschooled. So now the question for this family, what happened between this picture and the day he died, and is it possible signs were missed?
You have to see something is wrong there. They just don't go and, you're fine, and that's it.
Now, Eduardo's father and stepmother are expected to be in court tomorrow. They're behind bars tonight on $500,000 bonds. Live in the newsroom, Haley Bull, Fox 59 News.
Such